Thank you very much. I'm Jim Maurer. I'm chair of the University Senate, and this is our University Senate Spring University Address, which I always get wrong, which I just got wrong again. I'm so sorry. In any case, the university bylaws mandate that we offer a spring and a fall faculty meeting each year. This is the second meeting of this year, and we will be asking you in a moment to vote for approving the minutes from our fall meeting. You should have all received these by email, and I think we can do this by acclamation, although I suppose I should ask someone to move that we propose the minute, that we approve the minutes. Thank you, whoever did that. I appreciate that. I can't see a thing out there, but I'm assuming someone did. All in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Thank you. I think we've approved that by acclamation. Now, at this point, I'd like you also to remember to turn off your cell phones for the rest of the meeting. And also, we need to ask if there is any other business. Normally, we ask this after the whole meeting, but it gets crazy and it's ridiculous. Okay, seeing none, then I would like to introduce Mike Christakis, who is Vice President for Student Affairs. Mike.
Thank you, Jim, and thanks also for your leadership of the University Senate this past year and for your active engagement and participation as a member of the Strategic Planning Advisory Council, the STAR Review Work Group, and the Strategic Enrollment Management Council's Steering Committee. I know how much you love meetings. It's been a real pleasure to work alongside you, so thank you for your leadership. Good afternoon, everyone, and happy spring. As you know, April is celebration season on college campuses across the country, and UAlbany is no different. This past weekend, we concluded our third annual Recognition Week festivities with a conferral of the President's Awards for Leadership and the Spelman Awards for Academic Achievement. At both ceremonies, we honored our most exceptional students for their accomplishments in and out of the classroom. All of our students play an active role in the spirit and vibrancy of our campus. Indeed, UAlbany's over 300 student clubs and organizations are major contributors to campus life, community service, and engagement. I'm delighted to introduce members of Serendipity, UAlbany's all-female a cappella group, to you as they perform this afternoon. I'm going to actually introduce these young women to you this afternoon. First, join me in welcoming Miriam Joseph, a senior, triple major in criminal justice, sociology, and Africana studies. Natalia Dumont, a junior, double majoring in public health and gender studies with a minor in theater. Christina Warnstadt, a junior, psychology and music major. Giovanna Seiler, sophomore, sociology and communications major. Sagar Ndao, sophomore, business major and communications major. Jessica Davis, a senior human development major. And Nana Apoki Ajare, a freshman intended human biology and music minor. Serendipity, ladies and gentlemen.
Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good. Fish in the sea, you know how I feel. River running free, you know how I feel. Blossom on the tree, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good. Dragonfly out in the sun, you know what I mean, don't you know? Butterflies all having fun, you know what I mean. Oh, sleep in peace when the day is done, that's what I mean. And this old world is a new world and a bold world for me, and I'm feeling good. Scent of the pine, you know how I feel. Oh, freedom is mine, and I know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good. Oh, yes, I'm feeling good,
Thank you, Serendipity. Earlier this month, UAlbany welcomed over 4,500 accepted students and their families to campus at Accepted Student Open House. Many of you here today helped make that day possible. Thank you for helping welcome our accepted students to campus. That day, for the first time, we introduced our accepted students and their families to UAlbany in an epic welcome at the CEFQ Arena, featuring President Rodriguez, Interim Provost Wolfert, and Student Association President Lange Kadeska. We even included UAlbany's Marching Great Danes. Our accepted students and their families spent the rest of the day learning more about our academic programs, meeting our faculty, staff, and academic leaders, and interacting with current students. We also took the opportunity to remind them that, through our invitation to them to join the class of 2023, we saw greatness in each of them, that they were one of the greats. And we had them watch this video.
At the University at Albany, turn ideas into action. Turn curiosity into cures. Turn wit into glory. Turn passion into purpose. The University at Albany is home for dreamers and achievers just like you. At the University at Albany, unleash greatness.
Wasn't that a great video? Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you very much for being with us this afternoon. Muy buenas tardes to each and every one of you. Thank you, Jim, and thank you, Mike, for this convening. Mike, thanks for what you presented. We also have to always recognize, again, the always beautiful singing of Serendipity. And thank you, Jim, for the University Senate and everything that you and the University Senate do on behalf of this great university. For those sitting in the back, there's space towards the front, so if you want to come forward, please do so. We will be sitting here for a very long time. No, I'm just kidding. I hope that you feel inspired as I am by this video. I think it brilliantly captures the spirit and the essence of the University at Albany, a place of excitement, possibility, and achievement. Talking about excitement, 50 years ago, in May of 1969, the university dedicated its uptown campus. In fact, just yesterday, on this very same stage, we also celebrated the very same day, 50 years ago, the anniversary of UAlbany's Performing Arts Center. We gather to celebrate the impact of this center, our faculty, our staff, and students, and their role in expanding and strengthening the arts at UAlbany. For 50 years, in this very same room, we have experienced creativity, imagination, ingenuity, and innovation. We have awed, inspired, educated, and transformed our students and our audiences to the power of the arts. If you were not here, you really missed a great show with the Sakumu dance troupe of Ghana. We even saw some very nice dancing and great moves by some of our faculty, staff, and administrators, some who might be sitting next to you at this very point in time. You don't need to raise your hands. You know who you are. So let's give a big hand to Patrick Furlow and his team here at the Performing Arts Center for stewarding this critical resource for the University at Albany and for this region. As you came into the Performing Arts Center, we were distributing copies of the timeline that was part of the alumni magazine. If you haven't seen this yet, it was part of our outstanding recent issue of our UR alumni magazine, which celebrated the 175th anniversary of UAlbany's founding. Yes, I said the 175th anniversary of this great university. Please know there'll be other important milestones to celebrate throughout the year. So we are living in a very significant moment for this institution, a great time to learn, remember, and cherish our wonderful history. It is a great time to celebrate our achievements, both distant and recent, while facing current challenges and seizing the exciting opportunities before us. And it is also a time to build, define, and look forward to our exciting future. Let's imagine what was unmanageable a few years ago, speaking of the future. Before we go any farther, we have a new leader who will also be helping us meet those challenges and opportunities, Dr. Carol Kim. It is my great pleasure to officially introduce UAlbany's next provost and senior vice president for academic affairs, Dr. Carol Kim. Carol, can you please stand? And to Carol's right, Dr. Paul Millard. Please, Paul, Carol's spouse. And to Paul's right, Lily, their daughter. Lily, please stand as well. We are so fortunate and extremely pleased that Carol will be joining our team on August 1st, and very happy to have her on this campus this week as she gets to know the campus and our surrounding communities. As you may already know, Carol is joining us from the University of Maine system, where she is currently Associate Vice Chancellor for Academic Innovation and Partnerships. Before this role, she held a succession of academic and administrative positions at the University of Maine, including Director of the Graduate School of Biomedical Science and Engineering, Vice President for Research, and Dean of the Graduate School. Carol, as you already know, you were part of a retreat just yesterday with our Executive Council and the Deans. You are coming to UAlbany at a very exciting time in the university's history. I can assure you that since I arrived in September 2017, there has really never, ever been a dull moment. And we are working collectively to continue to build and strengthen this great institution. So get your roller skates and let's move forward. I want to thank as well the search committee for their excellent work during this extremely important search. We appreciate your time and your commitment and your leadership to ensure a successful search. And I would be remiss if I personally did not thank James Hyde in my office for really managing this complex search superbly well. So JD, wherever you are, there he is. Thank you so very much. I also want to thank Dr. Elga Wooford, who has taken the interim provost role with great energy, enthusiasm, and a great commitment. Elga truly loves this institution, and she loves our students. And we will be forever grateful for her leadership at this critical juncture of our university. So, Elga, thank you so very much. That said, Elga, please don't get too excited, because you have a few more great months to help us continue to lead this institution forward. But thank you for your leadership. As some of you may remember, soon after I arrived at the University at Albany, I asked my leadership team to recalibrate, align, and expedite three critical processes: strategic planning, branding, and the capital campaign. Since then, as a community, we've been doing a whole lot of recalibrating, aligning, and expediting. As a result, this charge is being successfully executed thanks to the hard work and commitment of so many of you in this auditorium today. Each of these initiatives has not only been successfully launched, but is moving down the road towards success. So at this time, I would like to spend a little bit of time talking about where we stand in each of these three critical areas: the strategic plan, the branding initiative, and the comprehensive campaign. Together, they represent our priorities, our goals, and tactics for meeting our mission and reaching our vision to be the nation's leading diverse public research university. So let's start with our strategic plan update. As you know, just over 1 year ago, we launched our strategic plan, authoring our success. And since then, we've all been working together to align our work, our efforts, and initiatives with our five core priorities. We then began the implementation process. Further, earlier this year, we began allocating funds for the strategic plan with leadership from our Strategic Plan Advisory Council, co-chaired by Mike Christakis, Vice President for Student Affairs, and Elga Wooford. Back in January, when we announced our Round 1 Accelerator grants totaling $2.4 million, which were linked to our core priorities, the annual Albany Book Festival, which had an amazing debut last September with an audience of about 5,000 individuals from the university and the surrounding communities, is an example of a major and transformative initiative that will be funded through an accelerator grant. And I do know for a fact that our nationally acclaimed New York Writers State Writers Institute and Paul Grandal sitting right over there, who was a great dancer last night, by the way, just in case you were asking, is hard at work pulling together a great lineup for our second annual festival. Earlier this year, we also announced strategic action items funding by reallocation of funding across units, totaling $1.6 million. Here you see a recent research fair organized by the Center for Undergraduate Research and Creative Engagement, at that time under the leadership of Janet Altarriba. And this was a recipient of reallocation funding, and it is an amazing asset for our students, which is focused on student success. The next phase of the strategic plan investments will be our STAR grants, or Strategic Allocation of Resources. These are micro grants. The RFP went out to the entire university community, and these micro grants of anywhere from $5,000 to $50,000. Any member of the community was eligible to submit a proposal targeted to three specific outcomes: to increase undergraduate retention rates, increase graduation rates, and diversification of our graduate student population. It is quite amazing that 88 proposals were submitted. This is truly remarkable and shows that our strategic plan is driving innovation across our campus. The STAR Review Committee, which among others includes representatives from the University Senate, as well as undergraduate and graduate student representatives, among others, has recommended 21 proposals, totaling $499,772. I'm just wondering why you couldn't spend the other $228. Is there an answer to that, Mike? No. You're working on it. All right. So we will now make a determination on the final funding for these final 21 proposals that have been recommended to me for approval. And as with all strategic plan investments, the STAR initiatives will be posted on the strategic plan website. So anything you want to learn about the strategic plan, take a look at our website. All the information is there. The next major investment after the STAR grants will be the round two accelerators, which will again originate with recommendations from the Strategic Planning Advisory Council, and we will start receiving those for the fall. Meanwhile, our metrics team has been hard at work vetting the high-level institutional metrics by which we will benchmark and measure our progress on our core priorities. So we want to measure what progress is being made and the success of these initiatives. This is the student success metric, and this is an example of a group of metrics we are considering for each of our core priorities. Again, our draft benchmark metrics are now on our strategic planning website. They are drafts. We ask you, we encourage you to take a look at the draft metrics and provide any recommendations that you may have. I am optimistic that over time we will start seeing measurable progress, because we already see many signs of success around us across the five core priorities. And let me just highlight a couple of examples of each of the initiatives we've been implementing, and there are many others which we will not be able to discuss today given time limitations. So let's talk about student success. As Provost Wolford recently announced, we have formed a graduate school which is going to increase the visibility and impact of graduate education at UAlbany and help with the marketing and promotion of our graduate programs. Incidentally, this is also a result of a reallocation funding initiative. As Mike alluded to initially, This weekend, we had the President's Awards for Leadership. Part of demonstrating student success is through these types of award programs. And this past weekend was a big fanfare for our students, family, faculty, and staff. And we also celebrated the Spelman Awards. Both our President's Awards for Leadership and the Spelman Awards were held in the CEFCU Arena on Saturday, and it was a packed house. We recognized academic excellence, leadership, service, and engagement. And we also celebrated student success and diversity, because these are important synergistic elements which represent who we are as an institution of higher education. I just also learned last night, actually, that two of our students were awarded the prestigious graduate research fellowships from the National Science Foundation. Heather Sussman at the Atmospheric Sciences Department and a PhD candidate, Alexander E. Seaman, a double major in interdisciplinary environmental science and mathematics, and also receiving honorable mention were Alex Marie Kuhn, a chemistry PhD candidate, and Chelsea Elizabeth Snide, an atmospheric sciences honors major. These are the types of accomplishments that we need to recognize and celebrate as an institution. Another great indicator of student success was our university's museum's collaboration with faculty from the College of Arts and Sciences to develop museum-based pedagogy. This was a terrific opportunity to provide students with hands-on learning experience not possible in a traditional classroom setting. We were also extremely proud that this project was featured as part of this year's Chancellor's Showcase at the SUNY State of the System Address. And now talking about research excellence. We are now celebrating the first anniversary of the New York State MESONET, which is the largest and most advanced system of early warning weather detection network in the nation. The MESONET has 125 sites spaced 19 miles apart, distributed throughout the state of New York, collecting all sorts of weather and other data every 5 minutes. What a great resource for New York State, for this country, and for the University at Albany. Celebrating our faculty, during this academic year, Paolo Forni, assistant dean in our Department of Biology, was awarded over $3.4 million in three NIH grants since September to study molecular principles defining neuronal identity and to investigate the genetic causes underlying congenital and degenerative neurological disorders. What an amazing accomplishment for an assistant professor here at the University at Albany. Further, Virginia Eubanks, associate professor of women's studies and political science, recently won the Fordham University's McGannon Center Book Prize for her book titled Automating Inequality. Her research explores the ways automated systems can worsen disparities between the rich and poor. And there are so many more great stories to tell about the success of our faculty, but unfortunately, time is limited. Moving on to diversity and inclusion. Among our initiatives focusing on diversity and inclusion, the Office of Graduate Education's Accelerator Grant is focusing on recruiting top underrepresented minority students from UAlbany and nationally. This is an initiative that is well underway, and they are partnering with the National GEM Consortium to host Getting Ready for Advanced Degrees or Grad Labs coming in the next few weeks. And incidentally, earlier today, we launched the Faculty Mentoring Initiative, a round one accelerator grant which will provide expanded support systems to increase success and retention among our faculty of color, and Dr. Tamara Miner is leading that initiative. And as many of you already know, we have had now several group meetings with the Women in Higher Education Initiative, which now includes over 50 women, faculty, staff, and students. We have established a steering committee under the leadership of Provost Wolford, and we are making great progress there as well. So thank you as well, Elga. In the area of internationalization, we seek to expand our global visibility, reach, and impact, and we are working to grow and expand international partnerships across our academic enterprise. The School of Public Health is an exemplar in international partnerships. We recently made two international trips to strengthen and expand these relationships with the University of Costa Rica, their School of Public Health, and our School of Public Health. And in Kazakhstan, we signed an MOU to strengthen and enhance our partnership with their National Medical University. We have also many such relationships, for example, between the Rockefeller College and Southwest University of Finance and Economics in Chengdu, China. We signed our MOU here in our campus center. Last December, we also participated in a signing ceremony at Chongqing University in China, which has a strong relationship with our College of Engineering and Applied Sciences. The College of Education is also developing very strong partnerships in the Dominican Republic, and the School of Business is fostering great partnerships in Cuba and elsewhere. There are many, many other such partnerships across our schools and our colleges, and we will continue to work and find new ways to create new opportunities for education abroad, faculty exchange, and academic and research collaborations. In terms of engagement and service, the university has done amazing work in this area. This slide represents some of our multiple trips of faculty, staff, and students to Puerto Rico following the aftermath of the most devastating hurricane to hit the island of Puerto Rico during the past 100 years. Between UAlbany and other SUNY institutions, we have sent close to 900 students in addition to faculty and staff to work in this island of U.S. citizens impacted by this devastating hurricane. Another recent event of engagement and service was a big event on April 6th. Again, as was referenced before by Mike, this year we took part in a National Day of Service where 1,200 UAlbany volunteers, students, faculty, staff, and community members participated in 41 volunteer opportunities with 19 community agencies. Think about the great service we provide to our community. A big thanks to the Center for Leadership and Service for leading our big event and to all who participated. We also held our first ever Short Takes, a series of featuring snapshot presentations by faculty, alumni, and other experts. We combined these events with our Admitted Students Open House, which Mike mentioned, that brought over 4,500 visitors to campus for the day, and this included 1,600 admitted students and their families. What a huge success this was, and this was a community effort with a lot of active engagement by faculty, staff, and students. UAlbany was certainly at its best that day as a publicly engaged research university. I could not be more proud of the hundreds of faculty, staff, and students that made this happen. And we are also very proud to have convened last fall at the University at Albany 19 of the 22 college university presidents from across the region. Now, if you've tried to get an appointment with the president, you know how difficult that can be, right? Imagine getting 19 presidents from the 22 colleges and universities across the capital region here at the University at Albany to discuss and collaborate to form a Capital Region Higher Education Leadership Consortium, which will be a voice for higher education, both in the region and in front of state leaders, while raising the Capital Region's profile as a national destination for higher education. I'm happy to say that UAlbany is playing a key leadership role in this process. And every year we host countless of other campus events, which is an important part of our commitment to community engagement. For example, earlier this month, the New York State Council of School Superintendents held a symposium of thought leaders on diversity and inclusion in the Campus Center Ballroom. This event was co-sponsored by a school of education and attended by superintendents and K-12 leaders from around the state. So we are a place that makes things happen for our community. And let me also take this opportunity to commend our Great Danes athletic programs, our student athletes, our coaches, our staff for their strong commitment to engagement and service. The Athletics Community Night was a powerful expression of this core priority. Finally, we recently celebrated the 7th annual Family Earth Day, led by students, faculty, and researchers in the Department of Atmospheric and Environmental Sciences and the Office of Environmental Sustainability. We are truly a strongly engaged university, truly committed to strengthening our ties with our local communities. We could not do that without you. And this is just scratching the surface of all the great work that our university does throughout the Capital Region and beyond. Let me provide now an update on our middle states and what progress we're making in terms of middle states. Our middle states reaccreditation self-study team, led by Deans Jeanette Altarriba and Jason Lane, has used the strategic plan as an organizing framework for our institutional self-study, which will be completed next fall with a visit from the external evaluation team in the spring of 2020. Thanks to all of you serving on the 7 work groups who are working on documenting our commitment to a process of continuous improvement. We hope to be sharing an early draft of our self-study with the campus community later in this spring for your feedback. And we really mean for your feedback. This will also be online. Go over it, provide your recommendations. Our co-chairs, thank you very much, and our committees will deeply appreciate it. So let us together make the strongest case possible for institutional reaccreditation. Now let me provide you an update on our capital or comprehensive campaign. As you know, critical to fueling our strategic ambitions and funding our initiatives is our comprehensive fundraising campaign. I am very proud to announce today that thanks to the hard work of many people in this room and outside of this center, we have reached $120 million of our $150 million goal. So if you're going to applaud, this would be the time. This success is yet another indication that this is truly our time. And it has been an amazing experience to see the tremendous support from our alumni, our friends, our supporters, our faculty, and our staff. And our success is greatly also due thanks to the record participation of our faculty and staff. And so we thank you very much for your support to the Capital Campaign. Your gifts are already at work, strengthening scholarships, providing internships, study abroad, funding new academic programs, and supporting faculty research. On that note, I am extremely pleased to tell you that our longtime faculty colleague and former dean, Dan Wolf, and his wife, Bonnie Taylor, have just made a gift to the campaign in the amount of $5 million. We could not be more grateful for Dan and Bonnie's amazing generosity, friendship, and support. In addition to committing funds to some amazing programs, both Dan and Bonnie are true believers in the fact that diversity equals success. As part of the campaign, we had an amazing opportunity just last week also to travel to California with our alumni association and staff from the Office of Advancement for several events, both in Los Angeles, California, and in San Francisco. We enjoyed getting to know so many alumni of all ages, from the class of 1947 to the class of 2018. But there's one constant. There's one constant among all these generations of classes. They remain deeply committed and enthusiastic about their alma mater and the transformational impact that an education at UAlbany had on their personal and professional lives. And both our dean and I and others can tell you that without exception, they all remember the wonderful times that they had at UAlbany, but without exception, they all mentioned the critical role that our faculty had in their academic and professional successes. Dating back to the 50s to recently, they would name the faculty that had touched their lives. And this reinforces the critical notion that student retention and student success starts in the classroom. Our faculty are key to the success of our students, and our staff also play a critically important role in student success. And so I would like to thank the Vice President for Advancement, for Dean Sinai, and my companion on trips for so many trips, the entire Advancement team, and the Alumni Association, along with our friends, supporters, and donors who are making the campaign such a resounding success. And so indeed we shall be, and we are confident that this is indeed our time. And alongside the campaign, we have unleashed a new brand on campus, on social media, and throughout our marketing, particularly in our recruitment efforts. And I wanted to give you a peek at some of the amazing assets that are being deployed in all different media. And so why don't we have a look at a TV ad that is playing in the market as we speak?
At the University at Albany, we see greatness in you. There's passion and purpose, a fierce curiosity, ready to blaze big ideas and tackle the tough questions. We see grit, drive, determination. The University at Albany is home for dreamers and achievers just like you. The world needs greatness, and you are one of the greats.
Can we give a round of applause to our team in the office? In the Office of Communications and Marketing for their very hard work in developing our new brand. Don't worry, we have about 60 pages to go. No, I'm just kidding. And talking about admissions and enrollment update, our admissions team, which as you know, are now under student affairs, is working closely with communications and marketing, aligning our recruitment efforts with our new brand and working hard to meet our enrollment targets both at the undergraduate and the graduate level. As I mentioned, we had an outstanding open house for accepted students just a few weeks ago, and we hosted 1,600 students and their families, and they got access to our great programs, information about this outstanding university, and had an opportunity to visit our beautiful campus. This is just one of the ways we have stepped up our strategic enrollment efforts for this year and moving forward with the support of the new Strategic Enrollment Management Committee, or SCMC, co-chaired by Elga Wolford and Mike Christakis. While the SCMC is charged with leading this institutional effort around predictable, sustained enrollment growth, it will rely very heavily on each and every one of you as contributors and champions of our current and future student success. I expect that the SCMC will come up with a plan on our strategic enrollment early this fall with detailed strategies to attract and retain and graduate students at UAlbany. So this is all very good news. However, there are also some warning signs on the horizon. Our first to second year retention numbers are in a negative trend, which is unacceptable. And unless we intervene aggressively and systematically, they will continue to decline. Unchecked, they will continue to decline. This is something we all need to be concerned about, and it is everyone's job to improve retention and student success. Right? There you go. However, that said, we have and will assign specific units and individuals to systematically and continuously and effectively address these important issues. I strongly believe that even for this fall of 2019, we can revert this trend. This is my expectation and my challenge to all those in this center and in this institution. I am confident we can turn these numbers around. And just yesterday, I challenged my executive council and the deans of this great university to do exactly just that. But this will also require your active engagement, your support, your commitment to make this happen. It doesn't happen by itself. It doesn't happen on its own. I want to reiterate that retention begins in the classroom. Our faculty play a critical role in this process. Student success is at the center of what we do. Thus, increasing our retention rates and our 4 to 6 year graduation rates is an imperative for this institution. We cannot wait. Now, don't get me wrong. All this happens by promoting excellence in everything that we do. And I want to reiterate that because increasing retention rates, increasing graduation rates need to be accompanied by excellence in everything that we do, and they go hand in hand. They are not mutually exclusive. So we will begin to have many more conversations in the coming weeks and months about how and what we can do better on this front. We must, however, collectively roll up our sleeves, get a handle on what we need to do, and go forth and accomplish these goals. Our focus needs to be on continuing to strengthen and expand student advising. We must continue to unfold the power and impact of faculty mentoring. We need to ensure that all our students participate in 2 or 3 high impact practices, including research, service learning, and internships. We need to significantly increase the number of students that participate in education abroad. We need to increase the numbers of students that participate in our honors program. We need to pay special attention to the health and mental health well-being of our students. We also need to systematically focus on the financial needs of our students. 1/3 of our students are first generation. 40% of our students are students from low-income families. 37% of our students are underrepresented minority students. We must understand the final constraints that these things pose to our students, and we need to address these issues. And we also need to reduce the administrative hurdles and obstacles that impact retention and graduation rates at both the undergraduate and graduate levels. And we must continue to focus on enhancing our campus environment and climate to make this a welcoming environment for all faculty, staff, and students. But, ladies and gentlemen, faculty, staff, and students, this starts at the department level. This starts at the unit level. If we treat our faculty, our staff, and students with dignity and respect at every level, we will continue to enhance and strengthen the role that this great institution plays in graduating our students from 1844 to 2019. That is what we need to do as a community. But we also need to enhance, strengthen, and build our research capacity. With the deans and the executive council yesterday, we discussed many ways in which we can do this. For example, we need to increase the number of and fill our current endowed faculty positions. We need to increase and value and support interdisciplinary, scholarly, and research collaborations. We need robust faculty development programming at UAlbany. And this is my call to the community, but we need to do this collectively and collaboratively in order to move this great institution forward. No one person, no one unit, no one division can do this alone, but together we can make, and we have made, and we will continue to make a great difference for this institution, for our students and our communities. And I am not 99% confident, I am 100% confident that collectively we can do this and much, much more for our students. So, what do you see in this slide? Dr. Slade, what do you see in this slide? Write us a poem on this slide. Opportunity or pessimism? I sincerely hope that it is the former, because there is a lot of opportunity. The sun is coming out, the sun will come out, and the sun will shine. And talking about shining, you recently received an update from Vice President for Finance and Administration, Todd Foreman, regarding the university's financial situation. As Todd described, through a collaborative approach, we have made substantial progress to balancing our budget and eliminating what we projected to be a structural deficit of $4.7 million is now gone, thanks to the great effort and collaboration of many of you in this room. We have achieved this mainly through workforce planning, as well as working diligently to identify savings and reallocate resources. I know, some of you are not fans and some of you are not too happy with the Workforce Planning Committee, and you are not enthusiastic about this process. Maybe you continue to be not too enthusiastic about this process, but let me tell you something, it worked. It has worked, and it has moved significantly the needle to move us in a very different direction with very positive results. So I would really like to thank the Office of Financial Management and Budget and the members of our Workforce Planning Committee for their very hard work. So Todd and colleagues, thank you very much, and thank you to all who are helping us move us to greater fiscal stability. As Todd would say, we are not entirely out of the woods. We will need to continue to be careful stewards of our resources while seeking to increase revenue through enrollment, state support, research expenditures, and philanthropy. Everybody plays a role in this process. If you want to know more details about a budget, I hope you will attend an open forum hosted by Todd Foreman on April 25th at 1:30 p.m. in the Campus Center West Auditorium. We want everybody to know every nickel and dime that comes to the university and every nickel and dime that leaves this university. It is not a secret. We want this to be open and transparent. And I want to thank our Vice President for Finance and Administration for the role he is playing in leading this effort forward. So in conclusion, give him a round of applause. So you may be happy to hear, in conclusion, it's been a lot of talking, I realize that. In this year of our 100, well, you're not there yet, hold on. In this year of our 175th anniversary, we have much to celebrate, many achievements of which we can be and should be very, very proud. Clearly, we have some hard work ahead of us, such as improving retention and graduation rates, growing our enrollment, increasing research expenditures, strengthening our financial situation, and diversifying our faculty. There are indeed many challenges in facing institutions of higher education across the country, including changing demographics, difficult conversations, national conversations about race, ethnicity, immigration, and free speech, and national conversations about the role, impact, and the value of higher education. But the good news is that here at the University at Albany, we are systematically having these very difficult conversations, and they are deeply embedded in our strategic plan and other initiatives. We are not shying away from the difficult issues. We have academic and administrative leaders that are dealing with these issues on a daily basis, and we believe and we are strongly optimistic about the future. We are looking to the future with our eyes wide open. We have clear and ambitious priorities in place. We are making the right investments, and we are putting in place the structures to measure and assess our progress to our mission, our vision, and our goals. And all this work has been done across our community, collectively and collaboratively, with increased channels of communication and accountability. I have been deeply impressed with the level of engagement and participation by our faculty, our staff, and our students, and your commitment to this campus community, and it shows. One of the most important ways our faculty continue to do this is through your engaged teaching and scholarship. That is what makes an institution great. And you have a tremendous impact locally and globally throughout your work. Our staff also play a critical role in the success of our institution and our students. Let us, day in and day out, recognize the hard work, the commitment, the engagement that our staff make to make sure that this institution is successful in every level and everything initiative that you can think of. When you see your staff around you, say, muchas gracias, thank you very much. And so we thank all of you for your commitment and service to excellence and student success. Thank you for all that you have done and continue to contribute as teachers, researchers, scholars, creators, and service providers. It is also critical that we continue gathering together as we have done today. And so while I have your attention for a couple of more minutes, I want to announce several upcoming opportunities and events that are coming. First, coming up on Tuesday, May 7th, the actual day of our 175th anniversary, we will be celebrating together on Dutch Quad at 2 p.m. You might ask why. To mark the occasion, we will be opening a time capsule that was placed under the podium in 1964. By the way, anybody know what's inside that time capsule? You do? Who said I do? Someone behind there said I do. I know who it was. Christy. And of course, May 17th and 19th is commencement weekend, our 175th commencement. As we announced last week, the speaker for our undergraduate ceremony will be Catherine Marinello, class of 1978, and president and CEO of Hertz Global Holdings. And this is very exciting indeed, so our students can know their accomplishments as well. It is also my great pleasure to inform you that we will be presenting the Medallion of the University to retiring chairman of the SUNY Board of Trustees, Carl McCall, at our doctoral hooding ceremony. This is the university's highest award, and I can't think of a more deserving recipient than Chairman McCall, who has dedicated his entire life and career to public service and public higher education in the state of New York and beyond. And I don't believe it's too soon to mark your calendars for our opening convocation on August 23rd, 2019. And soon after that, we will continue with our cycle of some new community traditions, like our community coffee hours in the campus center. Fardin, do you know that woman? Actually, she's sitting right next to Annetta. By the way, that is my wife, Rosie, photographed at our winter community coffee. And for those that don't know why she is smiling, I guess you can figure out why, right? So another new tradition we will continue is our university welcome for faculty and staff at the Casey Stadium. We had a great event last year, great food, great conversations, great colleagues. Please come join us for these important events. We would like to see more faculty and more staff. Come attend, encourage others to attend. But since we also had a little bit of fun at this event, it's always nice to have fun. We had exciting games, like the one you're about to see.
Any way you like.
I must admit that was my one and only shot, and that was, in case you didn't recognize him, Mike Christakis, who went in for a nice and cool dive. So thank you, Mike, for helping us entertain our audiences there. So I'm looking forward to working very closely with all of you as we work collectively and collaboratively to build and strengthen and enhance this great institution. I cannot tell you how happy and delighted Rosie and I are and how honored we are to serve this great institution. And we just look to continue to engage with you, to your commitment, to your engagement, your active participation, as you always have done, to continue to unleash greatness on behalf of our university, our students, and our community. Thank you to all who make this possible. Thank you for being here with us this afternoon. Muchísimas gracias. And I have been authorized to say that if anybody has any questions, there are two mics to your right and to your left. Please come to the microphones if anybody has any questions. No questions? Going once? I know we have one final question that's coming up. Who is it? Perfect. Thank you. No, that's not me. That's my double. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
Trap, trap, money, penny. This shit got me in my feelings. Gotta be real with it. Do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never ever leave from beside me. Cause I want you and I need you. And I'm down for you always, KB. Do you love me? Are you riding? Say you never ever leave from beside me. Cause I want you and I need you. And I'm down for you always. Look, the new me is really still the real me. I swear you gotta feel me before they try and kill me. They gotta make some choices, they running out of options. Cause I've been going off and they don't know when to stop. And when you get to top and I see that you've been learning. And when I take you shopping, you spend it like you earned it. And when you popped off on your ex, he deserved it. I thought you would've won from the jump, that confirmed it.
Once again, thank you to Damien, thank you to Petwin, and thank you to our dancers. Great. Please join us in the second floor for reception. We will welcome you to please join us, and let's have some great conversations. Thank you all for being here.